भीमातीर्णी वासाय मंडरी पुरवासिने पांडुरंग प्रकाशाय विठलाय नमो नमः मरुत्पुत्राय कवये भीमाय भयहरणे श्रीमदानंद तीर्थाय प्रख्याताय नमो नमः डियर चिल्ड्रन ऑफ गॉड जय श्री कृष्ण नमस्ते मेनी टाइम्स पीपल आस्क व्हाट डज सत्संग डू दैट इज व्हाट डज लिसनिंग टू अ रिलीजियस लेक्चर डू द आंसर इज द मैसेज फॉर टुडे सत्संग लिबरेट्स Men and women during the pandemic are very often pretending to be busy. Actually, either they have lost their jobs or they are working from home. Their income has reduced considerably. Their stress has mounted invariably. But their ego is so high that they do not want to go to God for shelter. On the other hand, they decry those who go to satsang. They call them escapists and call themselves as workaholics. They do not know the advantages of satsang. Dear devotees, by chance one gets into the habit of satsang, one realizes that it's a wholesome addiction with holistic effects. Without satsang, however busy one pretends to be, one will land up with some problem or the other, either mental disturbance or physical ailment. To bear this problem, the person needs inner strength, which is missing in the godless man. When one takes to satsang, these are the things that happen naturally, effortlessly. The Lord Himself tells us, when we take to satsang, that aversion to Godhead, that was unwillingness to listen to His glory at the outset, that is removed. That is the main block for satsang. All negative people have brainwashed the person in such a way that he looks upon satsang as a waste of time. He refuses to see the benefits of satsang. The moment he participates in it, his life begins to change little by little. He realizes what he has missed all along. He realizes that the initial aversion to satsang has worn off and naturally liking for satsang has dawned in his life. It's like tasting a new delicacy. The taste is new and refreshing. Everything is positive in satsang, while in the world outside is everything is negative. He begins to understand the presence of a kind God, a caring parent, an all-powerful king who is also accessible. He begins to understand that millions all over the world have believed in him for several centuries. He is slowly understanding that faith comes naturally to man in satsang. The various scriptures which are expounded by well-meaning preachers make him go deep into the understanding of God. The various lives of God believers stand before him in actuality and convince him that all is not lost. His pessimism is slowly fading away. The strong belief in God is now his goal. He yearns to know more and more about devotees and devotion. His thirst for spiritual knowledge is on the increase. He searches for answers to the question his doubting mind raises. Strange enough, he seems to get answers for them. This rebuilds his faith. That God, who looked like a distant fantasy, is now coming closer to him. He is real. His presence is palpable. Satsang begins to show him small miracles at first. These go a long way to further augment his faith. Finally, satsang liberates man, liberates him from his doubting self. It also liberates him from his lower self. If till then he had base desires and petty motives, he begins to live on a higher plane. He is amidst exalted company. When a man travelled by a village bus, he looked dust-laden and dirty. But when he takes his first flight with his educated rich son, he buys new clothes and shoes. Similarly, in exalted company, our disbeliever turns into a staunch believer, and all the incidents of satsang come alive before him. They are no more storybooks. They are eye-openers, calling his soul to the path that straight away leads to God. There are several appointments a man fixes during the day of his busy schedule. Satsang is an appointment with God, to whom one is bound since several births. A popular song says, Sangri se milne ka, satsang hi bahana hai. Sangri se milne ka, satsang hi bahana hai. दुनिया वाली क्या जाने ये रिश्ता पुराना है दुनिया वाली क्या जाने ये रिश्ता पुराना है सांवरे से मिलने का थैंक यू